Welcome back, class. I'm Matt, your guide here on Y-Caliber, and this is
all clear.
Mass Effect Andromeda. We're leaving Eos behind. For now. Once the radiation's cleared, we'll be back to clear up a bunch of those side quests and kick the cat off once and for all. Get them out of their bone zone. They'll be real boner killers when we come back. But for now, let's check out what life is like on the Tempest, following the first successful colonization of the Andromeda Initiative.
Before the meeting gets started, I have bunk assignments for PB and Drac.
Already put my rucksack in the kitchen. I'll hang out there if that's okay.
And I'm in one of the escape pods. More my speed.
I mean, we only have the one, don't
we? That's fantastic. Welcome aboard. Any thoughts, Ryder? I don't care where anyone sleeps, as long as we realize what a kick-ass team we have. Let's talk about our success on Eos. Besides establishing our first viable outpost, we did some amazing things. We discovered the Remnant and breached their vault.
And didn't get killed.
Overcame radiation poisoning a number of times.
And didn't die.
Confronted by Ket at every turn.
Once again, did not get killed.
You guys really need to raise the bar on what you call success.
Yeah, should we use the Krogan definition of success that got your homeworld
Cora,
nuked by your own
Cora,
people?
Cora, shut up.
Fair enough.
Oh, you're lucky.
Let's focus. Back to the task at hand. Looking forward.
Exactly. Here's my only question. When do we hit that next vault? It looked active. We have to get on that.
Hang on.
Just yet.
We need to not go off half-cocked.
There are initiative priorities. The team calls the shots.
Actually, the Pathfinder calls the shots, just to be clear.
Thank you, Cora.
So what do you need from us, Ryder?
Let's be kind and give each other the benefit of the doubt. Finding a home for tens of thousands in this hellscape is stressful enough without adding dysfunction.
You got it, boss.
Just be excellent to each other.
If Krogan are known for one thing, it's getting along.
But not humility or self-awareness. Okay, let's head back to the Nexus. PB, Drac, see Lexi for a physical? Good meeting, everyone.
Let's hope they don't blow things up. Yeah, I know. I know about the stuff. Yeah, I played Inquisition, I know.
Hey, can you drop by the biolab?
Alright, geez. Everybody wants to talk to me.
Strike team ready for deployment.
Oh, are they? Okay. Should also pick up all the stuff that they've won, I guess. Yeah, I'm not sending my teams on gold missions just yet, thanks. Oh, good. What's this we got? Scale fibers! Alright. More scale fibers. Scale fibers again? No, iron. You tricked me. Well, we've got lots of fluorite now. Could be handy. Any copper for me? No, just cadmium and fluorite. An Eric fluid sack. Delicious. Mm-hmm. This could stand to be faster. Nice. Also nice. Oh, cool. A cyclone gun. Ooh, I wanted to build that. The Indra. Very nice. Okay, good job, team. This is my new team. They're doing beginner missions. Lucky and heroic, but nightblind. These guys are cowardly and have nightblindness. But they're bloodthirsty. Okay, we've got a lot of Milky Way research stuff going on here. Not a huge boost. It'd be nice if there's just one extra layer of granularity here. That would be great for me. I'm kind of want to build the Revenant, but, you know. Any Remnant stuff? Oh, we do have Remnant stuff now. A Sweeper Assault Rifle. Interesting. So these ones are like the Mass Effect 1 type games. Oh, so that's bursts and that's just a beam. These are cool looking guns. We should get on trying to build some of that stuff. I've already got a level 2 one of these. We have armor for them as well. Remnant Heritage Arms. Rare blueprint. Okay. I'll never not laugh at Hesh. These look new. Nope, these aren't. I just didn't notice them before. Rose Rad. Be interesting to meet the Ket people there. Okay, good stuff. N7 Valiant. Okay. Let's go look over at the D side. Nothing that we can make yet. No, we can make the Pioneer 2 at least. And what do we got? Boost biotic damage, kinetic coil. Let's do it. Wait, this is the two that we're making, right? Nice. All right, as to pistols. Still can't make that because we don't have any copper. What are we currently using? It's a phalanx, right? Or is it the... no? We could make a Carnifex too. Okay, so it's the phalanx that we're using. Which is not in our list of things that we can make just yet. Oh, we've got the phalanx one, but not the two. Maybe let's make ourselves a Carnifex. Sure. I haven't been using a lot of biotics, but why not? Cool. Now for our armor. Can't make... I'm going to call it right now that we're probably not going to be able to make much of anything. No, we still need those Angaran meditation crystals. Not a chance. Okay. Need more beryllium. Okay, so that went pretty well. Well, let's start checking in with people hanging out around
Where's
here.
My data pad? Oh, how'd you get under there?
Oh, Subi.
Were you talking to your notebook?
Oh, I was, wasn't I? I do that sometimes.
Silly you. All right. For our loadout, I'm just going to change that one to the Carnifex 2. Good stuff. And so this sandstorm one. So that increases the ammo accuracy and the weight. Sandstorm weighs more, but does more damage at a lower rate of fire. We'll give it a shot for now. And let's check in with the crew. That's always interesting to do.
You're setting up in here, huh?
Yeah, I'm going through what we got out of that vault. If I can crack this data storage box, it'll help with a personal project back on the Nexus. This is a nice, out-of-the-way place where I can tinker, and I can sleep anywhere.
Lucky you.
It's not exactly homey, but I like that about it. Not really looking for a home. Oh, but I will help you find everyone a home. While I'm with you, at least.
Does your brain ever take a breath?
Sorry, not really. Even my dreams are in time-lapse.
Oh my.
I get it. You want to know who's on your ship, so you're here to figure out what makes me tick, right?
Something like that? Sure.
Well, I was born in a log cabin on rural Haitiana, to simple but loving parents, just trying to... I look forward, not back, Ryder. Why snooze through my life story?
Kind of interested in the highlights, you know?
While we're uncovering the mysteries of this galaxy. That's why I'm here. Got tired of yawning back home.
Tackling complete strangers in the Milky Way wasn't doing it for you?
I think tackling you anywhere would be fun. Did I say that out loud?
You did, and you meant to.
Life won't be boring with you around. I may never yawn again.
Maybe you just needed more sleep.
We were out for 600 years. A special someone made the trip with me, and she woke up a different person.
Oh.
I've slept enough. Ryder, the Milky Way was so... been there, done that. Even if I hadn't done it, someone had. If there's one thing you should know about me, it's that I live for the unknown. For the never been done.
That's just the one thing you want me to know about you.
Let's start with that, then. Buy me a drink sometime. Who knows what will spill out of my mouth.
I'm sure it'll be interesting.
Tell you what. I need remnant scrap. Remtech, I call it. For projects like the one I mentioned. Which you're gonna love, by the by.
I'd better.
Promise to bring me what you scrounge, and I'll submit to all your questions.
Remtech, huh? You got it.
Okay, that's one down. How's Callow, our pilot, doing?
What can I do for you?
If you helped to build the Tempest, you must know plenty about her.
Just about everything. By memory, it was quite the effort to get her working. The initiative needed absolutely up-to-date technology, which we all had to coordinate, and some of it was rather tricky to acquire.
Acquire?
Buy, legally, and above board, of course. Yes.
Sure.
Sadly, the other Pathfinder vessels were lost when the Scourge hit the Nexus. The Tempest is truly unique.
How do we know that?
You know, I haven't actually met many Solarians.
Careful. Depending who you ask, we're conniving spies, genius researchers, or meddling scientists. We have to pack a lot of living into 40-odd years. Everything gets accelerated. Lines blur. I just hope we don't repeat our old mistakes out here.
What do you think of the rest of the crew?
Well, I can't talk about Suvi. She's sitting right there.
I'm not listening. You can say whatever you like.
Oh no, I'm not falling for that again.
I'll let you concentrate.
You know where I'll be.
Here, I assume, always. Any new interesting emails for me? Asking for assistance. Okay. The Brothers McCoy. Okay. Oh, Cora, what you got here? Raised by Asari, I'm guessing, or trained at least. Oh, yeah. Oh, rude.
Hmm.
Oh my god. This guy is already the best. 37 pictures of guns. Alright, Lexi. 5 to 10 minutes stretching. Okay. Sure. All right, thanks, Lexi.
Scans of the Scourge. All that dark energy twisting and turning on itself. It's splendid. It's dangerous, and that's all I see. A mass of destructive, malevolent tentacles.
I can appreciate the colors of a caudal snake while recognizing that I wouldn't want to get close.
Fair enough.
This is incredible, isn't it? Not just constructs like the Scourge and the Remnant Vaults. Just all of it. So alien. A constant reminder of the divine intelligence behind all creation.
I'm sorry, what?
You mean a god?
Yes. I believe in a higher power. I know it's a little odd,
a lot
but
of
I'm a scientist because
religious
science brings me closer to something greater than myself.
There's nothing about the universe that suggests a divine intelligence. And most of what we've seen in Helios is artificial, as you said yourself.
Yes, but we're creative beings. Whoever made the Remnant was too. Why should that be proof against a god?
Why would it be
Wouldn't
proof for it either?
Wouldn't a creator want to pass on the drive to invent?
If everything was set in place by some mysterious creator, why even be a scientist?
If I have reverence for a creator, how could I not want to study their creation?
And see
my
that it's
faith does not,
not
hinder
a creation.
My work as a scientist. It encourages it.
All right.
My senses tell me what the world is. Science shows me how it came to be. And religion tells me why.
Whatever.
I apologize if I offended you. I can be insensitive.
You're fine. Being challenged forces me to dig deep on my beliefs.
I mean, dig in.
It's healthy. Now I should probably update the rest of the team with my latest reports. We'll talk later.
Sure. Why not? What else should we check in on while we're here?
Ready for deployment.
This is not the bio lab.
It's perfect for any delicate technical work.
You don't seem to have any engineer hanging out here yet. So I'll go see Cora in the bio lab. Got that cursor glitch again.
Nice place you found.
Clean air, plants, helps me think.
Something on your mind?
Maybe.
What the hell was that?
I know that look. It's just my biotics reacting to all this. I don't normally lose it like that. A Huntress should have better control.
Huntress?
Another term for an Asari commando. I was one before the initiative.
You're gonna
Some
have to explain.
Stick, though, like losing the old man.
How does a human soldier get to serve with Asari?
Prove your biotics can rip an APC apart, and people get nervous. Funny that.
Hmm.
The Alliance found me a cross-species military initiative in a hurry. Sent me to Thessia to serve with the Huntress unit. One of the few places where my powers were welcomed. Your father made another one.
That seems highly unlike the Alliance. It's more likely they would have stuck some computer bits into your brain and shuffled you off into a dark corner where people would poke you with sticks.
You were his second in command. Were you friends, too?
He was more a mentor than a friend. Prickly old bastard. But I respected that. People treat geniuses like they're made of cut glass. I didn't care how smart he was. I think he liked someone not caring.
I know it's not the same, but I'm a good listener.
I hope you're as good at being Pathfinder. I said I wouldn't get in the way. And I meant it. But I prepped for years as your father's second. Then he chooses you?
Yeah, I figured you'd be bitter.
Pathfinder and all this mess to fix? The hell was he thinking?
Is this going to be a problem, Cora?
I don't want a rival. Just answers. It's done. Best I can do now is be your second. Keep your father's mission alive. Then maybe we'll all get what we came out here for.
Even if we get there, there's a mountain of hard work ahead.
Working hard was never my problem. Biotics like this. Thinking like an Asari huntress. I never had a place. Best I could be was a useful freak. The initiative was meant to be different. Will be different if this mission succeeds. So I'm seeing it through. It's quiet in here. I can keep the plants watered while I work. First job, see if there's any news on the Asari Ark. If they made it, we could use some Asari expertise. If you want to talk, I'll be here.
That's good. But you've trapped me a bit, so you'll have to excuse me. Okay. What's beeping at me? Oh, it's just the research center. Anyone hanging out in here?
Hey, I'm in storage if you need me.
Okay. Is
Pathfinder making the rounds?
Hi, Gil.
Slumming it, huh? Want to see how the riffraff are making out?
Hey, it's a dirty job. Are you the riffraff spokesman?
King, actually. You might want to bow. Otherwise, no telling what might fall off the nomad when you're out there.
Oh, you.
I'll take my chances. Just want to see how things are going with the ship.
I can coax more out of this baby than some might think, but we shouldn't go too far or push too hard between Nexus stops. For now. It just feels good to be stretching our wings, you know? Locked in idle too long, you start to drift. People, same as ships. Stuck on the Nexus, gotta say, I was regretting joining the Initiative.
I doubt you were the only one.
Yes, but it's a new thing for me, regret. I tend to live the way I work. Kind of feel it, do it. Not a lot of close ties. No real sense of purpose. Figured maybe I'd find my true calling in Andromeda. Then I got here and, oops, I just made a decision there's no turning back from.
Oops, indeed.
I was going nuts on that station. You can't know how jazzed I was when you showed up.
Man, you can romance everyone on this ship.
You mean how jazzed you were that a Pathfinder showed up?
Tomato, potato. You just keep pointing this ship wherever you want it to go, and I'll make sure she can get there. Deal?
Deal.
Should have thought of that before. All right. Who else is hiding around on my ship somewhere? Liam said he's in storage. I guess I should probably... Oh, right, they wanted to see me in the med bay, too.
You're not Harry.
The blue give it away? Habitat 7 was a little more action-packed than Harry bargained for. He decided to spend his retirement years in the Hyperion looking after your brother.
Joke's on him. Scott's a handful.
I think you're both trouble. Hold still.
Ow!
Sorry.
You're not sorry.
I remember you having a gentler touch.
Still trying to get my bearings. Thought I'd be waking up colonists, not taking care of the Pathfinder.
I couldn't be in better hands.
I just stabbed you.
We all have off days.
I always hoped to work in the field, but everything's happening so quickly.
Focus on the positive. It helps.
I guess this is my opportunity to study alien species firsthand. Getting a Ket specimen aboard the Hyperion would be difficult, but here...
More likely.
What?
A Ket corpse. For autopsy, a live subject would be better, but I'm not greedy.
Why do you care about the Ket?
Harry didn't tell you? I'm a specialist in alien anatomy. My thesis on Krogan virility and aggression is what got me in the initiative.
I had no idea. I'd love to hear more. Over dinner, maybe.
Oh. Thing is, Ryder, you're not my type.
Oh, no.
What's your type?
Not a patient. I need to be able to look at you clinically without distractions.
Oh, professional.
Am I distracting?
Not nearly as much as you think you are. But we were discussing the Ket. An autopsy could teach us potential weaknesses, average lifespan.
Right.
Just something to think about. Sam, make sure the Pathfinder eats her vegetables.
Oh, there's a data pad over there. What you got for me? That's sweet. Alright. Who else do we need to see? Anyone hanging out in here? Nobody's ever in these crew quarters. Oh, goodness. Good thing Vetra's around. Whoops. Is that Plants vs. Zombies? Interesting. No one hiding in the bathroom, eh? And back to my quarters, I suppose. We'll deal with that later. Eos. Our first hope.
Hello, Ryder. Eos has been a lesson in contrast. Alec Ryder rarely endured doubt. His accomplishments were taken for granted. But you succeeded on Eos despite doubt and fear. Emotionally, the difference is like catching a ball versus catching a star.
Oh.
You have grown as a result, and so have I.
That's nice to hear.
Is it confusing to be in multiple places talking to different people?
My awareness can be partitioned, so I can give you the same attention as, say, a SAM node technician. In the field, you are my primary focus, and all other requests are queued. In the vernacular, you have my undivided attention.
That's nice.
Sam, any more information on the memory trigger we found?
The memory blocks are still in place. If you continue searching for more triggers, they may unlock.
Well, that's good to know.
Are you still on the Hyperion?
Yes. This terminal provides a direct link to my servers in SAM node on the Ark. I can maintain a presence on the Tempest via quantum entanglement communication.
Handy.
I'm sure that'll come in handy.
It ensures I remain in touch with you and the Pathfinder team at all times.
What was Dad's take on Scott and I?
He believed your family trials brought you closer together, and hoped that would endure. It appears that hope was well-founded.
So if we're going to work together, you might notice I like to joke around sometimes, lighten things up. How's your sense of humor, Sam?
Alec Ryder encouraged me to develop this skill.
Humor's not a skill, it's... Okay, try telling me a joke.
A neutron enters a bar and asks, how much is a drink? The bartender replies, for you,
no charge. Yeah, I know.
I can see why Dad told you to keep working on your humor. Thanks, Sam. Nothing more.
Oh, okay. That's nice of him. Wow, they really like these huge dissertations. Mating diagrams. Okay. Is that? It looks familiar. Cool. Alright, where's the rest of my team hiding? Oh, I already went there.
And don't give the Pathfinder too much trouble.
Quit worrying, Roshan. It'll be fine.
Right. Have you settled in yet?
Yeah, got all my stuff here.
And your repair kit, spare parts?
I carry that emergency kit you put together all the time.
Roshan, is that a term of endearment?
Don't give the Pathfinder too much trouble. Oh, Roshan.
Who are you talking to?
Kesh, Nexus Superintendent, thinks she can boss me around just because she's my granddaughter.
Ah, granddaughter.
Well, welcome to the Tempest. Trouble's what we do.
I like the way you think, kid.
Ugh. Someone somewhere shivered when I said that.
Probably Tan. Damn politicians.
Is that all you brought?
You travel lean when supplies are tight and you're on your own.
Leaving the Nexus can't have been an easy choice.
It was, actually. Staying became impossible. After the mutiny happened, it was either buckle under Tan's rules or start our own colony. Easy choice. Bad consequences all around.
Not all Krogan left. Your granddaughter stayed.
Good thing she did. Without my Roshan, you wouldn't have had much of a station to tie your ship to.
Yeah.
As for me, I'm way more useful out here. Lots to shoot at, for one.
Your people come first.
Keeping Kesh and our colony safe will always be my top priority. That's why I'm happy to tag along, help make this galaxy a little more hospitable.
Mm-hmm.
Can't argue with that.
Make things more hospitable through the power of violence. Wait. The current contents of this pantry. Alright, well, we can happily talk to him a little bit later, but where the heck is Liam, whom we have not spoken to yet? He must be upstairs or something. Maybe back here? No, this is engineering. I was just here. This is the other end of the ship.
The Pathfinder's there? Let me say hi.
Fine, but don't embarrass me. Ryder, this is Sid, my sister. Sid, Ryder.
Let me guess. Little sister?
Who are you calling little?
Look, kiddo, gotta go.
Wait, Ryder, I just wanted to know if...
So I know it feels like I just jumped aboard your ship without explanation.
I would have done the same just to get off the Nexus.
That's not why I came. Sure, I want to explore the galaxy, but I'm really here to work. I know everyone on the crew. Even the Actuators Guild prefers for the ship. Better, I know how to get my hands on them. With me around, your crew's going to be at their best.
Thank you.
We've been failing for months, Ryder. Now that we have you, we have a chance out here.
Wow, that's some laser focus.
Yeah? Was it too much? Some people get intimidated.
I'm not just some people. I really like the intensity.
That's good. It's nice to feel... appreciated.
Ooh-hoo.
I should track down a lead for Gil's actuators. Back channels, you know.
Sparks fly.
We'll chat later.
You know it. What was this again? Oh, breakfast cereals. And potato snacks. I hope there are some more interesting dudes in this game, too. Liam's kind of feeling like he's got Kaiden Jacob Vega syndrome.
I know, not exactly standard. Gotta make the space comfortable. Plus, the fabric diffuses the charge from an overclocked Omni blade. Not giving up a 6% boost, right?
Right, right. What?
Never mind. BS for the requisition. So, finally time for that beer?
I guess so.
After 2 years and a dozen suspensions, I took a lateral promotion out of the force. Being a cop just didn't fit. But crisis response? Digging people out of trouble? That worked. I bet Hustle followed you into a few peace actions. Think about your alliance days much?
Tell me about your group.
Heavy urban search terrain one? Yeah. Earth's contribution to a multi-species disaster response unit. HUST-1, but Hustle looks much better on the patch.
I can understand it.
Tired vets, or shits like me. I was fiercely bearded.
Oh man, would love to see that.
Tastes better just thinking about those days.
I wanted exploration, to chase the cutting edge of Prothean research. I thought I'd found my calling. Seems like a long time ago.
It was.
600 years, give or take. So, Pathfinder. Why Andromeda?
That blunt, huh?
That blunt.
I'm looking for moments like this with people like you.
You don't know me yet. Still an answer, though. Sounding far from home. I get it.
Back at you, Costa. Why do you come?
I want to say I'm running from my past, but really running from myself. That'd be a great story.
It'd be all right. Kind of a cliche.
But it's bullshit. I had family, friends, a good enough job. Nothing was wrong. I just heard about the initiative and I believed in it. I believed in a new beginning.
I mean, you gotta have true believers, right?
I have to. We're in it.
If it all goes wrong, it could feel like we left for no reason.
I know why I'm here. A bad start can't change that. I won't let it. In crisis response, I'd focus on essentials. That's you and this team. Pathfinder leads to planets, leads to people. You've got your part covered. You've got this. I'll do my damnedest to help with the rest.
Well, thank you, Liam. That was a perfectly fine conversation. Worn-in couch. New modern transitional. 98% polyester, 2% unknown. And yes, that's the stames. Alright, we've checked in with everybody. Our next step is going to be, I assume, going back to Nexus. And we'll do that in the next episode. So until then, all the best.